Ladies and gentlemen, in this video, I'm going to say two words that will probably polarize you. Squirrel Acorn. Welcome back. My name is Seth Estrada, and if you're watching this YouTube video, you're probably on my YouTube channel, Seth Estrada. Good to see you back, lovely audience. Let's talk a little bit about FPGA mining in this ongoing series about FPGA profitability. And without having hard numbers in front of me, again, this is a moving target, so I apologize that there aren't a whole lot of hard numbers for this video either, but I wanted to address a couple of the conceptual concerns that came up in the comments from my last video. And one of the biggest questions that I got was, hey, what's your opinion of Blackminer F1? Or the biggest comment, what's your opinion of Blackminer F1? That seems to me to be the most popular option. And I hear this from several miners who want something that's got high ease of use. Now, let me be clear, I've got nothing against the team that produces the Blackminer F1. I think it's a phenomenal product for what it's worth. However, it is an appliance. It's not a discrete FPGA. Let me draw a distinction here. Nobody would say that a brand new GPU launched by AMD is a complete mining system. We know better than that. It's not. It's a component. But an appliance, everything that's all inside of one little tidy little box, that looks an awful lot like an ASIC, doesn't it? Yes, ASICs are appliances. ASIC miners, rather, are appliances. You can get an ASIC that's in a development style board, a bit like developer board FPGAs, but those wouldn't be very helpful for mining, would they? So with FPGAs, however, they're designed to be put into a development environment and designed to be changed multiple times. The Blackminer F1 might be a little more difficult to do that with, loading your own custom bitstreams, and specifically loading bitstreams that leverage the processing from multiple different chips. Think about that. Without a very high speed interconnect, like say Infinity Fabric on AMD, or say a PLX PCIe switching chip that allows you to give a lot of bandwidth between mining elements, it's going to be hard for something like the Blackminer F1 to ever load really heavy duty, really compute intensive algorithms like say x16r. That said, it's always possible, never say never. I don't know what the state of development is for the Blackminer F1 team, but I do know that x16r has been the subject of a lot of focus by bitstream developers and FPGA developers, mining developers, for several months now. This is what I got. A developer leaked this to me, and look behind me right here. This is just a screenshot. I'll let you see the entire video in a moment, but this is a high-res screenshot of miner. What's this? Found two SQRL DMA devices. Device one, 215 plus, ostensibly the Acorn CLE 215 plus. Device two, also a 215 plus, running what bitstream? X16R version 0.007. What? Okay, so it looks like there's been a few revisions of this bitstream already. Device 1 assigned to worker 1, device 2 assigned to worker 2. And these two devices are ready for mining, forcing a specific clock speed as per whatever the start script is, starting to mine on Stratum TCP pool BSOD port 2176. Now, what is BSOD port 2176? I'm going to tab over to the BSOD website. You see it right there. That's BSOD. And what is 2176? It is the X16R Ravencoin pool. Yep. Port 2176. So validated right there. That's definitely where they're trying to mine. And here's just a refresher on the SQRL website, the Acorn CLE 215 plus. This is the product page. And it's still retailing for over $300 per unit. So what we're seeing in that screenshot represents $660. Thank goodness. Oh my gosh. Thank goodness it isn't $666, because that would just be like a marketing nightmare. Wow, wow. Just kidding. Anyway, so let's scroll down and just get a refresher on what it is that the Acorn CLE 215 Plus promised when initially launched. That is to say, what the copy here kind of prepped us to expect. It's right here, more coins, more performance. Lyra 2 RE version 2, X16R, Verge, Ravencoin, Monacoin, etc. Run mine them better. Of course, Vertcoin has since forked to Lyra 2 RE version 3. But ostensibly, mine them better by adding Acorn CLE 215 Plus to your mining rigs. You can mine some coin without additional hardware, and your mining rigs are safer against changes in cryptocurrency algorithms. So you can give a little more longevity to some of the GPUs that you already bought from seasons past. Or if you're like me, but you know, from suckers who sold out the weak hands from last year. I don't mean to be disrespectful. Sorry. Thank you. Appreciate your sacrifice. Fallen Heroes. Dual CLE 215 Plus. And notice that it gives us approximately double the performance of anything that's listed here. So X16R, 30%. But on dual, 60%. Let's look back again at Lyra 2 RE version 2, 23% with a single acorn and 47% with dual acorns. So having two is better than one. It does scale pretty much linearly, at least from this chart here. But what's this? Down below, standalone usage with a CLE or with a Threadripper. Apparently, maybe some CPU acceleration down the line. I think that may be what the SQRL team had in mind. But there were some bit streams and there were some algorithms that SQRL had in mind when launching this product. So if we're to solo mine, it sort of vaguely says, and more. And I think it's safe to say, based on this screenshot, this leak, that the and more may include X16R. Or what we're seeing in this screenshot is the beginnings of a bit of acceleration where some of the algorithms that can be done more efficiently on the FPGA accelerator are being done on the FPGA accelerator with the additional parts of the multi-algo cycle also being completed by the Acorn, just not being completed as efficiently as a GPU would. So at any rate, that is that's kind of the long and the short of it. Yes, long and the short of it. Let's jump back into here. So it says it's ready. Stratum state idle, connected. And we'll go through that full video in just a moment here. But I wanted to ask you a couple of questions. Because the question came up towards me, what do I think of appliances like the Blackminer F1? Well, again, I think it's a perfectly fine device. However, I do think that it has a limited duty cycle ahead of it because it doesn't have high speed interconnects the same way that other devices do. The Acorn Miner, for example, it has four lanes of PCI Express connectivity. And when placed on a unifying board like the Acorn Nest, it can communicate at very high speeds between other Acorns on that same board, or it can communicate with additional GPU hashing elements or other FPGA hashing elements on a high speed, high bandwidth motherboard. So it can do a lot of good. Same with BCU 1525. It has QSFP ports along the front. Same with CVP 13. These are components that were designed from day one, designed to be interconnected with very high bandwidth to additional compute components that would allow users to do very difficult things and allow the compute power of one of those devices to scale in a greater than linear fashion. When does 1 + 1 = 3? When it's an FPGA that has a high speed interconnect. That was really corny. Anyway, but I'm really tired. So I'm not going to explain this anymore. Enjoy the video. Answer my question. What do you think of the Blackminer F1? You know my thoughts on it now. And after watching this video, tell me it in the comments. What do you think the prospects are in the near term, midterm, and long term for FPGA mining on coins like Ravencoin and Gincoin, as well as Gravium and others that use X16R and X16RT? Let me know it in the comments. As always, thanks for watching the video to this point. Appreciate you pressing the subscribe button, clicking the bell icon so you're notified when new videos like this go live. You are the reason I make these media. I love your face. I'll see you in the next one.